University of Auckland's graduation ceremonies. This is our third ceremony today, and this particular one is for the Faculty of Business and Economics. Very soon your students or graduands will be coming in. Please do feel free to photograph them as they do this, but please be considerate of the people around you who are also trying to do the same thing. After the students process in, they'll be followed by the academics and then the official party. During this time, please remain standing, and please do feel free to join in the singing of Gaudiamus. Now would be a really good time to switch off your mobile phone. Then we won't growl at you. At the end of the ceremony, we will all sing the national anthem together with your graduates. When the official party leaves, the graduates will follow them. Please wait until all the graduates have left the auditorium before following them out. They're all here, so please stand for your graduands.
Please be seated. Inga mana, inga reo, inga hoe fa. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Vice-Chancellor, Pro-Chancellor, Council members, special guests, staff, graduands, family and friends of graduands. As Chancellor of the University of Auckland, I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of University Council members and staff of the University. In particular, I welcome our guest speaker today, Mr. Bruce Hassell. This is a meeting of the Council of the University of Auckland for the purpose of conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. This week, we will be conferring and awarding more than 7,000 qualifications on some 6,400 students. In person and in absentia. At this ceremony, 443 students will graduate in person and 240 students will graduate in absentia. I will be assisted today by Mr. Peter Kiley, Pro-Chancellor, in awarding diplomas and conferring degrees. This is a happy and memorable occasion for you, the graduands, as well as your families and friends who have supported you during your studies. We congratulate you all. Equally, your achievement brings pleasure and satisfaction to the academic and professional staff of the university who have played their part in your success. The graduation procession today brought academic flavour and colour to the streets of Auckland, and in this ceremony, you'll experience the pomp and tradition befitting your well-deserved day of celebration. Over a period of 130 years, the University of Auckland has become a comprehensive, research-led university with a strong international reputation. Today, there are more than 40,000 students and 5,000 staff. Moreover, We are New Zealand's largest research organisation, with one-third of the country's externally rated world-class academic researchers. Within New Zealand, only our university is ranked within the top 1% of the world's universities. We also have a strong commitment to Māori and Pacific education. Of all the Māori degree graduates in New Zealand each year, 25% come from just one institution, the University of Auckland. The figure for Pacific graduates is 40%. We jealously guard our position amongst our competitor universities and are always looking to create new opportunities for all our undergraduate and postgraduate students. Last month, we confirmed the purchase of the 5.2 hectare former Lion Brewery site on Kaiba Pass. This purchase will provide the university with a site for expansion over the next 50 years and is contiguous with the City and Grafton campuses and with the major business centre in Newmarket. We will occupy the first of the new facilities on that site in November 2014. So as you graduate, please reflect on the ongoing learning opportunities and consider the wide range of postgraduate options available to you at Auckland. I ask you to consider that because we can never rest on our laurels, especially in a challenging and ever-changing world. Whatever path you follow, I urge you as alumni of New Zealand's leading university to never forget your alma mater. We rely on our graduates for support, moral, political, and financial. Funding constraints are a perennial problem for New Zealand universities, who are being asked to do more and more with less and less each year. In fact, in these hard times, we should be spending more on universities and not less. But that is enough of the substantial issues facing us all as members of a 21st century university with high aspirations, because today is your day. The focus is firmly on your achievement. And at this ceremony, we honour your success along with the support of your family, whānau, and others who have sustained you through your studies. I congratulate you and trust that you will long cherish the memories of your graduation here today. I'm delighted to welcome as our guest speaker, Mr. Bruce Hassell, the Chief Executive of PricewaterhouseCoopers and an alumnus of the University of Auckland. Bruce graduated from the University of Auckland's Business School in 1980 with a Bachelor of Commerce degree. He is currently the Senior Partner and Chief Executive Officer of PricewaterhouseCoopers New Zealand, with over 30 years business experience and 25 of these years as a partner. Bruce is responsible for the executive leadership of the New Zealand firm, the determination and execution of strategy, and all aspects of the firm's relationships with other PwC member firms and PwC International. He headed the firm's assurance practice for 4 years and is the lead partner for several of the firm's major clients. Committed to making a difference in today's business landscape, Bruce is a member of the New Zealand Institute of Chartered Accountants. He is a board member of the New Zealand China Council, the University of Auckland Business School's Advisory Board, and the Diverse New Zealand Governance Board. He also sits on the Financial Markets Authority Capital Markets Disclosure Panel and Global Women's Diversity Governance Group. Please welcome with me, Bruce Hassell.
Chancellor, Vice Chancellor, members of Council, members of the University, graduates, family and friends, good afternoon in a rather wet Auckland day. Thank you for having me back today where I graduated just a few years ago, if only. I'd like to tell you I'm the same young man who proudly passed his Bachelor of Commerce degree in accounting from this great university. Saying that, like a very good wine, I've slightly evolved and changed with the times. Once you've been in the workforce for 30 years, experience the pride of going to your own children's graduation, like so many of you in the audience today, and all the wonderful experiences of family and life can bring, you don't get quite so hung up about staying the same. In fact, some change is probably good for you. Being here today also brings back my own memories of graduating. The feelings of joy and pride, mixed with just a little bit of fear, some worry, nervousness and apprehension about the future. Out there in the real world for the first time, I think my dad used to say to me, working for a living. My university's comfort zone gone forever. As a parent to three young adults, with the youngest enjoying her first year at the University of Auckland. In fact, some aspects of what she's enjoying I'm a little bit concerned about, but that's another matter. This graduation ceremony also brings home the aspirations and worries that I have for my own children. As the chief executive of New Zealand's leading professional services firm and the largest employer of graduates in New Zealand, something we are very proud of, and I occasionally remind the Vice-Chancellor of that, and seeing some of the graduates we've employed here today, it fills with me with an excitement about the opportunity you all have to make a real difference in the years ahead. Will you be successful? Will you live and realise your dreams and aspirations? Will you show courage when it is required? Big questions about yourself and your life. How will you answer, graduates? What I've found from my own life journey is there is nothing in life is worthwhile unless you're prepared to take some risks and step outside of your comfort zone. Let me share with you a story that involves Denzel Washington, the acclaimed American actor that illustrates this point. Denzel, of course, being the second African American actor to win an Oscar. He has some great life lessons to share. I was very fortunate to hear Denzel give a speech at a sitting very similar to this in America a few years ago. The theme of his speech was all about falling forward. Remember that. I came to the conclusion that I have more in common with this award-winning actor than I, or probably many of you out there, would think. Anyway, Denzel talked about his philosophy in life, which had driven his success. And his philosophy was all based around falling forward. Now, I should say, initially when he started talking, nobody in the audience had a clue what he was going on about. But that quickly changed. To set the scene, Denzel quoted Nelson Mandela. This was the quote. There is no passion to be found in playing small, in settling for a life that's less than one you're capable of living. Really powerful. Denzel talked about the advice he received when he first went to university, and a lot of people told him this. Now, Denzel, whatever you do, make sure you have something to fall back on. I, in fact, received similar advice. I even still get that advice, but I suspect it's all a little bit too late. Denzel talked about how he never understood the concept of having something to fall back on. If he was going to fall anywhere, he was only falling one way. He was falling forward. He also liked to see, he said, what he was about to hit. I think that was the actor thing in him. Throughout his career, including the many failures and false starts, and he started uni as a med student for a semester, then he tried law, then journalism, and finally drama, and of course his acting success. He did tell everybody, and it's great that I'll be able to share this today, he then went on to say he didn't try business because he found that all a bit too scary. But the key thing that he said, but always front and centre in everything he did, was based on his philosophy of falling forward, of not being afraid to take risks, picking himself up after any failure that he had, removing the security blanket, the comfort layer, and going for it. I like to think his philosophy is best summed up by this expression: to get something you never had, you have to do something you never did. Every graduate here today has the ability, the skills, and the talent to succeed in their chosen field. But do you have what it takes to fail? Because to realise your life and career aspirations, your dreams, in a world that is changing at an unprecedented rate, you will need to go the distance. Are you prepared to nudge right up to the fail line? I believe you owe it all to your families, the university, and everybody that's helped you through your education to do exactly that. When I reflect on my own life journey and career, there have been some pivotal moments when I could have taken the easy option, throttled back, felt the warmth of my comfort blanket, and it is warm up here, I can assure you of that, and watched life's opportunities just fly by me. I didn't. I have a pet saying I often use in staff coaching sessions: you need to reach up and grab life's opportunities because nobody is going to lower them down to you. So my advice to you today, graduates, is this: be courageous. Don't be afraid to fall forward and back yourself. Put that conservative cloak in the bottom drawer. Smile nicely at the naysayers, but don't listen to them. Embrace a winning can-do culture and celebrate success. Know that you won't always win, but don't let failure knock your confidence. Always challenge yourself and try new things. Enjoy life. Accept different opinions and ideas and be open to all views. At times, this may be a little bit frightening, but it will be so hugely rewarding. Because your future, your career, your success is just that, it's yours. You choose it, you live it, you make it happen, and you can all make it happen. New Zealand, and for that matter the world, needs more people like you. People who are ambitious for the future and who can positively contribute to society and make New Zealand a better place for everybody. So take those uncomfortable but healthy feelings of apprehension and fear you may be feeling and drive your future forward. Never let go of your confidence, your determination and focus. And remember, there is no substitute for hard work. So please stand out and make all of us proud. Be the success we all know you can be. Celebrate what you have achieved here today and remember the lessons of those of you who have supported and guided you through your studies. And most importantly, enjoy the next stage of your life journey and be happy. Thank you very much.
Bruce, thank you for a speech which was insightful, yet entertaining and inspirational. Thank you very much. Can you join with me in thanking Bruce again for his address? This is a meeting of council in convocation of the university at which the Pro-Chancellor, Peter Kiley, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of the ceremony.
By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Peter Kiley, Pro-Chancellor, confer the degrees and award the diplomas stated upon those who, within the faculty, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
Thank you. I call upon the Deputy Dean of the Faculty of Business and Economics, Professor Wong, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Deputy Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Business and Economics. Graduate Diploma in Commerce, Aninya Barua. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Matthew James Davis. Nicholas Joe Fong. Kay Lin Fu. Blathlin Allard James. Maya Joy Adrian Jones. Natasha Shavinda Kumar. Ivy Wei Ching Lam. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, John Lee. Bishendri Naika. Shuhadran Bhuvanisen Pathmanathan. Raj Rani. San Sukayasen. Ane Poane Talakai. Ashley Gemma Vanderbeek. Yanjing Wong. Wai Wu. Fan Yong. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce. Ariane Ashinta Jui Ashimsai. Abra Ahmad. Trina Grace Tooha Iunu. Faisal El Abayachi. Carl Sean Albuquerque. Safia Nazneen Ali. Albert Ankiri Wong. Mayur Ramlal. Cecilia John Anthroper. Jose Angelo Du Aranas. James Anthony Bailey. Ko Samuel Simbarashi Barai. Jason Michael Bell. Katie Lee Bell. Stephen James Benson. Alexander Claire Berry. Andrew James Biddle. Michael James Bloxham. Elena Dickinson Bloom. Craig Richard Bott and a graduate diploma in commerce. Helen Bracewell Worrell. Jessica Lee Brown. Bianca Tony Brusciweiler. Jaden Michael Buckley. Mohammed Alfan Busk. Joshua Allen Burgess. Kate Ellen Butcher. Aaron Joseph Mendoza Cabellas. Andrew Alexander Cackett. Liesl Leanne Kearns. Craig Chow. Shi Chow. Liam James Allen Carr. Panodpon Charungroj. Pac-Man Chan. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Elaine Chan. Nikita Chauhan. Jane Nagech Chia, and a Graduate Diploma in Commerce. Elisha Chia Su Vern. Marissa Clarice Challen. Chia Chi Chen. Dan Ching Chen. Natalie Xiaoping Chen. Ting Ting Chen. Ji Yong Chen. Xiong Yong Cheng. Marian Aisha Cherrett. Kai Hin Chuk. Kenny Chun Kit Jung. Tin Chung Chung. Wai Ting Chung. Cheng Hao Chiang. Kai Shun Chiao. Su He Cho. King Yu Chow. Lisa Pei Hoi Chow. Fiona Chua Fong Yi. Lily Pa Sinja. Sophia Martinovich Clark. Catherine Jean Collins. Sarah Jane Connolly. Christopher Coote. Matthew Philip Cope. Jenica Rachel Cowan. Michael Jason Cox. Jessica Joy Cribbins. Caden David Crombie. Nathan Thomas Croucher. Daniel Joshua Cullum. William Barrett Curry. Todd Emin Cutfield. Tyler Ashley Dan. Victoria Ann Davey. Sean Nicholas DeRuys. Xiang Dang. Kevin James Denali Minturn. Brana Trennant Dennison. Mumtaz Natalia Dole. Hao Hui Dung. Dung Jie Chun. Scarlett Bridie Downs. Yevgeny Dryden. Sia Du. Yiman Du. Xuan Doi Duong. Greta Jane Duxfield Smith. Lucinda Antonia Edwards. Jesse Lee Chloe Ellis. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Guang Chang Samuel Ng. Adele Erasmus. Maria Ignacia Escalante Ugati. Maria Lourdes Haygood Itasio. Natalie Fakuri. Shu Chi Fan. Robert Fazikas. Fei Fei Foon. Joshua Savio Fernandez. Naotala Jonathan Fasolet. Tom Harvey Fletcher. Sir Kwan Fu. Christina Fowler. Kelvin Serene Francis Julian. Abhishek Siddharth Franklin. Ching Ha Fung. Xie Qin Gao. Siyun J. Gag. Victor Nelson Gerard. Thomas Anthony Gilbert. Jim Guang Hoon. Florence Odity Gomes. Maria Gonyunova. Devashan Govinda. Riona Govinda. Jeremy Tien Green. Sharanjit Kaur Greville. Anku Grover. Ching Yul Gu. Laura Carly Goodfin. Nathan James Gunn. Yaroslavna Vidimarovna Gusiva. Jordan Ari Daniel Haynes. Rebecca Ellen Hall. Jiong An Han. Margaret Joy Hansen. Kitten Manilal Harry. Rajan Harish Parbu, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Syed Shahaya Cameron Hashmi. Regda Hassan. Anita Jane Hayhoe. Rajitha Mivan Flint Hemachandran. Megan Bridget Henderson. Jerry Lee Philip Hettit. Mitchell Hetherington. Carissa Bernadine Hoons. Richan Kentumbuhan Hizong. James Ho, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Ka Yun Rebecca Grace Ho. Ho Kang Lee. Brad William Hogan, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Courtney Allen Holden. Matthew Kim Holder. Alexander Mark Hopkinson. Sally Hall. Katrina Mary Horsford. Ho Siang Jia. Sorry, what's your name? Michelle Hua. Li Hua Wang. Yan Wang. Ikfa Iqbal Huda. Jared John Huddleston. Nicholas Anthony Hudson. Christopher Hammond Hughes. Manhim Tyron Hu. Shi Ting Hung. Christopher John Hunt. Daniel Francis Hessler. Yeah. Ko Sung Hin. Benjamin David Inovale. Wataru Inoue. Samantha M. Iqbal. Azan Irani. Owen Luke Isaacson. Woo! Luke Junior Chukwudinbim Iwazi. Nicole Sarah James. Tyler Michael Raymond Jealous. Thomas Robert John Jennings. Pei G. Wan Chi Jia. Zhang Yue Zhang. Wan Tai Zhou. Eloise Claire Jones. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Kailin Beryl Yan Pang Jones. Ju Hun Jung. Jiwon Jung. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Conjoint, Kiyati Acharaya and a Bachelor of Arts. Catherine Emily Ensters and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Ashley Shu Bay and a Bachelor of Property. Koyol Bajpai and a Bachelor of Property. Rajat Shidharath Bakshi and a Bachelor of Health Science. Shri Prashanth Belarus and a Bachelor of Health Sciences. Christopher David Robert Bamber and a Bachelor of Arts. William Thomas Bingham and a Bachelor of Science.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Linda Filimoihala, accompanied by Dean Sky Lucas, will now perform Grandfather's Clock by Henry Clay Work. Thank you. Linda, thank you for a wonderful performance. Hearing Grandfather's Clock again takes me back to my own childhood days. Can you all join with me in thanking Linda for that wonderful piece? By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Business and Economics, have satisfied the requirements of this university. I now call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Business and Economics, Professor Whitred, to present further graduands in that faculty.
Ladies and gentlemen, I apologise for the interruption here. Could I please ask the parents and family of Joshua Fernandez to meet me in the Owens foyer, which is level 2 just outside here. Thank you very much.
To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Conjoint, James Edward Brooker and a Bachelor of Arts. Matthew Nicholas Burberry King and a Bachelor of Arts. Luke Leroy Paul Butters and a Bachelor of Arts. Lisa Marie Campbell and a Bachelor of Science. Justine Chan Yi Chia and a Bachelor of Arts. Tegan Rose Cheeseman and a Bachelor of Arts. Vivian Hui Tong Cheng and a Bachelor of Arts. Yu Wen Cheng and a Bachelor of Arts. Alixia Chana, Bachelor of Arts. Vera Qian Pei Yu and a Bachelor of Arts. Ming Yu Qiang and a Bachelor of Property. Jonathan Chi On Cho and a Bachelor of Science. Charles Guo Chi and a Bachelor of Laws. Sheng Yan Chui and a Bachelor of Arts. Dipiksha Daya and a Bachelor of Arts. Rebecca Keen Y. Dobie and a Bachelor of Arts. George Drummond William Dosey and a Bachelor of Arts. Andrew James Dodge and a Bachelor of Arts. Kirsten Jennifer Edwards and a Bachelor of Arts. Kara Ali Escure and a Bachelor of Arts. Justin James Ewens and a Bachelor of Arts. Rachel Helen Feenstra and a Bachelor of Arts. Celeste Jane Gosling and a Bachelor of Arts. Samuel Dunbar Grice and a Bachelor of Science. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Divya Hariharan and a Bachelor of Arts. Luke Benjamin Hilditch and a Bachelor of Arts. Andrew Max Hill and a Bachelor of Arts. Xu Yu Huang and a Bachelor of Arts. Lillian Rosalie Jones and a Bachelor of Science. Patrick Conrad Jungi and a Bachelor of Arts. James Davis Kidd and a Bachelor of Property. Parvathi Krishna and a Bachelor of Arts. Alex Chunhei Lam and a Bachelor of Arts. Lu Bao Lam and a Bachelor of Arts. Mandy Lan and a Bachelor of Arts. Stephen Jeremy Lazarus and a Bachelor of Arts. Jordan Lee and a Bachelor of Arts. Carl Lamley and a Bachelor of Arts. Zhao Li and a Bachelor of Arts. Amelia Sumun Lok and a Bachelor of Science. Yen Ting Lung, and a Bachelor of Property. Jia Hong Lo, and a Bachelor of Arts. Ronak Mahant, and a Bachelor of Property. Devon David Manchester, and a Bachelor of Arts. Haresh Rakshan Mather, and a Bachelor of Property. Ishbel Emma MacDonald, and a Bachelor of Laws. Todd Michael McFlynn, and a Bachelor of Property. Caitlin Ann McKenna, and a Bachelor of Arts. James Timothy Miles, and a Bachelor of Arts. Kimberly Jane Mundy, and a Bachelor of Arts. Hayden Zilin Ng, and a Bachelor of Science. Meng Yuan Crystal Ng, and a Bachelor of Science. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Etin Fergus Oliver, Bachelor of Engineering Honours with First Class Honours in Computer Systems Engineering. Daniel James O'Sullivan, and a Bachelor of Property. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Hanita Pamar, and a Bachelor of Property. Malvika Porulkar, and a Bachelor of Science. Amanda Victoria Pierce, and a Bachelor of Arts. Thuy Tan Phan, and a Bachelor of Science. Tisha Cassandra Pinto, and a Bachelor of Arts. Lisa Roanne Pook, and a Bachelor of Arts. Lisa Heather Porter, and a Bachelor of Arts. Priya Shurez Prakash, and a Bachelor of Arts. Nirali Hazmak Shah, and a Bachelor of Property. Priya Dasni Singh, and a Bachelor of Science. Emma Jane Smith, and a Bachelor of Arts. Hamish Robert Smith, and a Bachelor of Property. Matthew Robert Smith, and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Tatiana Althea Suarez, and a Bachelor of Arts. Pratik Sridhar, and a Bachelor of Arts. Sui Jane Tan, and a Bachelor of Arts. Kathleen Tanumi Haja, and a Bachelor of Arts. Yvonne Itwon Tai, and a Bachelor of Arts. Zhu Xiao Daniel Choi, and a Bachelor of Science. Keiko Yumezu, and a Bachelor of Arts. Karen Ng, and a Bachelor of Arts. Nikolai Mario Volanovic, and a Bachelor of Property. Zoe Lee Walker, and a Bachelor of Property. Xu Ting Wong, and a Bachelor of Arts. Simon Joseph Warren, and a Bachelor of Arts. Jacqueline Sao Ming Yung, and a Bachelor of Arts. Jenny Jane Yip, and a Bachelor of Arts. Yue Yao Ju, and a Bachelor of Science. Postgraduate Diploma in Commerce with Distinction, Gennady Viktorovic Persinen in Information Systems. Postgraduate Diploma in Commerce with Merit, Christopher James Gracie in Operations and Supply Chain Management. Ginny Park in Accounting and a Bachelor of Commerce. Peter Stowers in Management. Yashan Zhang in Management. Postgraduate Diploma in Commerce, Andrei Arestov in Management. Sung Lee in Management. Michael Malua Wolf in Management. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with First Class Honours, Bronwyn Louise A. Kitt in International Business. Kajul Bajpai in Accounting. Deeksha Bansal in Accounting. Kelsey Ellen Benji in Marketing. Amy Emiko Aolani Bonham in Management. Shanil Vikash Chand in Finance. Irene Lingjin Chu in Accounting. Sharon Susan Chuang in Accounting and a Bachelor of Commerce. Penica Garin Cortez in Accounting. Yeah. University Graduate Scholar Bobby Joy Dunstan in Economics. University Graduate Scholar Marco Oichter in Finance. Banafsha Hajati in Marketing and a Bachelor of Commerce. University Graduate Scholar Maylin Han in Finance and a Bachelor of Commerce. University Graduate Scholar Rachel Ann Harker in Accounting. University Graduate Scholar Yu Chen He in Accounting and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jason Alexander Thomas Hill in Accounting. Daniela Karen Howitt in Finance. Shuang Hu in Accounting. University Graduate Scholar Jin Huang in Finance. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours First Division, E. Abid Hussein Al Atafi in Marketing and a Bachelor of Commerce. Abhijay Bhattacharya in Commercial Law. Harleen Bharti in Marketing. Ian Richard Black in Commercial Law. Frank Fahei Chu in Economics. Jacqueline Tama Sawilau Salevalasi Fui Moano in Marketing and a Bachelor of Commerce, Bachelor of Laws, conjoint. Kenneth Mark Goodall in Economics and a Bachelor of Commerce. Ji-Hai Han in Accounting. Nathaniel David Harding in International Business and a Bachelor of Commerce. Wing C. Jessica Ho in Marketing. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Amy Rose Anderson in Commercial Law. Shirley Al, Commercial Law. Glasgow Chung, Commercial Law and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jem Rerikohu Giori Thompson in Commercial Law and a Bachelor of Commerce. To the degree of Master of Business Administration, Nick Ali Aryan. Anthony Allen Barton and a Postgraduate Diploma in Business Administration. Richard Jan Anthony de Haast. Samuel Katigbak Dignadisi. Anna Louise Dawson. Roger Kenneth Duncan. Vineeth Paulson Erangeri. Ryan Malcolm Frost. Helena Jane Gibson. Gary Richard Hamilton. Bernard Anthony Hill. Nathan Robert Egbert Hooker. Damien Nicholas Horn. Alan James House. Param Kataria. Susan Mary Kleinsman. Aaron Keith Lane. Damien John Lawrence. Joseph Ko Ung Ling. Doreen Chi San Leo. Rebecca Jane McDonald. Kumaran Mangala Kumar. Leah Shaborn Marin. Alexander John McDonald. Jared Malcolm McGregor. Anthony Leslie William McNamara. Peter Rees Montgomery. Hee Bin Park. Vivian Elsie Pole. Brent Kenrick Pownell. Bruno Relic. Helen Claire Ryder. Ravnur Deep Singh Saini. Digby Raymond Seals. Nicholas Paul Shea. Melody Ann Smith. David John Taylor. Susan Raywin Tullett. John Harry Wagner. Grant William Wardell. William George Graham Wright. To the degree of Master of Commerce with First Class Honours, Minggang Chen, Information Systems. Hui Dong, Operations and Supply Chain Management. Jonathan Neil Glenday in Management. Jingjing He in Information Systems. Wenchen Ng in Information Systems. Michael Christian O'Burl in Information Systems. Glenn Nicholas Riddell in Economics. Dawei Yu in Accounting. Yu Zheng in Accounting. To the degree of Master of Commerce with Second Class Honours First Division, Deng Tai, Economics. Fen Jiang in Information Systems. Zhu Liu, Economics. Laura Francis Pei Moana Lolo Hia in Management. Lauren Catherine Smith in International Business and a Postgraduate Diploma in Commerce with Merit in International Business. Jared Andrew Ye in Accounting. To the degree of Master of Commerce with Second Class Honours Second Division, Adrian K. Eady in Management. Kio Tukuturangi Moriahu Kaori Rawiri MacDonald in Economics. Sione Fangatofa in Accounting. To the degree of Master of International Business with First Class Honours, Pamela Martinez Roman. Arthi Sundar. Ning Xu. Anna Zubkovskaya. To the degree of Master of International Business with Second Class Honours First Division, Jose Luis Huesca Dorantes. Priyanka Kaliwa. Nikita Kanduri. Jung Yun Ku. Juan Camilo Rodriguez Arenas. Yeah. Yashita Singh. To the degree of Master of International Business with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Uzia Alim. Roland Atta Anyangwe. Hiromoto Kudo. Yu Luo. Caitlin Denise Van Nostrand. To the degree of Master of Management, Anne Margaret Moore.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Matthew Puravadi Abraham in Finance. Matthew investigated the determinants of the decision by firms to adopt and underwrite a dividend reinvestment plan under the dividend tax imputation system in the Australian market. Matthew. Lee Chen, an accounting university doctoral scholar. Lee examined financial analysts' incentives to react conservatively to information about future earnings. She found evidence suggesting this is due to their reputation concerns rather than short-term economic gains. The findings have implications for regulators and investors in the equity markets. Rong Gong in Finance. Rong investigated the impact of the 2007 reforms on the information environment of Chinese stock markets with a view to the policy making in Chinese financial markets. Hasniati Hamza in Property. Hasniati critically examined the institutional and behavioural dynamics between urban planners and residential property developers involved in the provision of low-cost housing in the state of Terengganu in Malaysia. Her research offers important insights into the efficacy of government intervention in the low-cost housing sector. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the Book of Convocation qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Business and Economics.
Teaching Excellence Awards. The university places considerable significance on excellence in teaching. It recognises this by making awards each year to teachers who have demonstrated excellence in aspects of teaching. These awards are contestable across the university and signify a truly superior achievement. An award for early career excellence in teaching has been made to Dr. Barbara Plester in the Department of Management and International Business within the Faculty of Business and Economics. I call upon a student of that faculty, Amy Bonham, to read the citation for Dr. Plester.
I am delighted that Dr. Barbara Plester is a recipient of the Teaching Excellence Award. I was an undergraduate student studying psychology and management when I first met Barbara in 2007. Entering into my university career, I'd always imagined a future for myself in psychology. Management was plan B. Barbara changed that. Barbara uses an impassioned teaching style, engaging students with material, coherently explaining key concepts, whilst also offering alternatives and critiques to further enrich the learning experience. Barbara brings subjects to life through the use of case studies, her own experiences and literature. There's always a good class turnout at her lectures. Barbara has also sought to stretch her students and further develop the collegial environment within the Department of Management and International Business. Students are challenged to examine beyond the bounds of established theory, to explore and analyse the taken for granted. The challenge to investigate further and to live up to her high academic standards instills in students a sense of the importance of achievement as well as a desire to achieve. Barbara commands a lot of respect, respect for her passion and knowledge of her area of expertise, and also respect in terms of the way she treats her students. She values independent thinking and is open to intellectual reciprocation with students. Through this process, I've been able to develop my own capabilities and capacity, eventually leading me to make the decision to undertake further studies within the field of management. Now, I am a master's student and am entirely grateful to Barbara for the encouragement in my undergraduate studies, the guidance into postgraduate study, and finally, for the supervision of my honours dissertation and master's thesis. I know that Barbara deserves a Teaching Excellence Award because from my very first lecture, she's shown me how fulfilling and exciting learning can be.
An award for innovation in teaching has been made to Associate Professor David Sundaram, Mr. Andrew Eberhard, and Ms. Gabrielle Pico in the Department of Information Systems and Operations Management within the Faculty of Business and Economics. I call upon a student of that faculty, Nalini Singh, to read the citation for the group.
Undoubtedly, inspiration is the greatest gift we can give to one another. Inspiration comes from the Latin word inspire, meaning to inflame, to blow into. This is epitomized by the designers and teachers of information systems and operations management 110, business computing, Gabrielle Pico, Andrew Eberhard, and David Sundaram. David teaches with style, with energy, and with amazement. Being in his classes is at once a highly imaginative and highly structured experience. He continually forces us to transcend the boundaries of our current knowledge while also keeping us grounded in the present. Andrew creates an atmosphere where learning is a step below inspiration. Every lecture is extremely interesting. He continually forces us to transcend the boundaries of our current knowledge while keeping us, while having us undertake independent learning. Gabrielle connects with his students and creates a comfortable, immersive knowledge space where each individual is encouraged to challenge and overcome their preconceived learning limits. All three educate in the strongest way possible by motivating existing knowledge from within. Their philosophy comes from Plutarch. The mind is not a vessel to be filled, but a fire to be ignited. Their innovative design of information systems 110, lecture and tutorial process, content and activities maximize student participation and engagement by captivating, connecting, and cultivating them through passion, cohesion, and simplicity. While this course is almost akin to learning a new language, what makes it so attractive is being able to form coherent sentences at every step. Each stage has been laid out with the utmost precision and clarity. Business and technology have been made real, relatable, enjoyable, and of immediate relevance and applicability through technology-mediated exercises, videos, simulations, and the use of artifacts. The assignment made us put theory into practice. It's an exercise, essentially, in creativity that drives us first to imagine a better world and then to make it happen. We entered our assignment into the Microsoft Imagine Cup, and we're one of the top teams in New Zealand. We also won awards at the Spark Entrepreneurship Challenge. This course made me believe that I can make a valuable contribution to society in the things that truly matter to me: health, education, poverty, and the environment. In a word, I feel inspired. Andrew, Gabrielle, and David are worthy recipients of the Innovation in Teaching Award.
We've reached the end of this graduation ceremony today, so on behalf of the university, I'd like to invite all of today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. This would also be a good time for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieved their qualifications. Thank you. This concludes the meeting of Council and convocation of the University for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you to stand and sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori, then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of the programme.